A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 11th September, on the front page you have polls for block development councils in Jammu and Kashmir by month end. So now the schedule for elections to 316 block development councils in Jammu and Kashmir will be announced in a day or two. So this actually is the election which will be completed before the state is formally converted into a union territory. So that will be done on October 31. So elections for this will be announced now and will be held. So these are local elections. That is, the panchayat elections had been conducted. You can see. So the panchayat elections have been conducted, and now the next step is block development council, and above it is Zilla Parishad. So these polls are the next steps, and the government is keen. The central government is keen on having these elections conducted, and so these are planned now. The panchayat elections have already been conducted. Block development council polls will be conducted now. Then this is India counters Pakistan statements on Jammu and Kashmir at UN Rights Meet. So India has declared that Pakistan was trying to polarize the UN Human Rights Council to advance its agenda in South Asia. So India has responded to the UN body. There was this UN body's UN Human Rights Council 42nd regular session in Geneva. And an Indian diplomat shed light on the contradiction between Pakistan's attempt to champion human rights in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir and the denial of the same rights to various communities within Pakistan. Then below you have Delhi NCR takes pole in India's startup grid. So Delhi National Capital Region is home to 10 unicorns, and with one new unicorn emerging each year. And you can see the study says that Delhi has accounts for 23% of all startups set up in the country as of 2019. So this is the term used. Unicorn means startups. On page 6 you have Odisha villagers bid to save their homes from soil erosion. So the villagers here have concerns about soil erosion and sea erosion, and now they have started digging and cleaning the Bahuda river mouth. So this is in Ganjam district in Odisha. So blockage of the river's mouth and formation of sandbar and opening of new river mouths have been identified as the reasons behind sudden rise in sea erosion. So it is threatening the existence of the villagers here to at Ramayapatna. So that is why they have started working on it. And this is government looks at disaster management tool. So this is regarding Maharashtra government. It is going to take help of US agency too. And flood damage crosses 14,000 crore in a decade in Mumbai metropolitan region alone. So this is US Development Agency, US Trade and Development Agency, whose help will be taken by Maharashtra government to reduce the damage caused by floods. And here you have 14 dams put on high alert in Gujarat after heavy rain. So Gujarat continues to be battered by heavy rains, and it has prompted authorities to put more than 100 dams and reservoirs on high alert. In Sardar Sarovar Dam too, water has reached 136 meter mark. Then on page 9 you have Tabrez lynching. Police drop murder charge. So the family members of Tabrez Ansari, who was lynched in Jharkhand about 4 months ago, have accused the state police of weakening the case by turning down the charges against the accused. So the charge sheet submitted, it seeks prosecution against 11 accused under section 304 instead of section 302 of IPC. So this point has been raised. So instead of the much stronger section 302, section 304 has been applied. Then below you have MP to offer cow for adoption online. So Madhya Pradesh government is going to launch an online service for those wanting to adopt a cow and provide sheds to them at gaushalas across the state. Then below you have two new species of ginger discovered in Nagaland. So, northeast climate is conducive to genus diversity, And here we have seen two new, we are seeing two new species of ginger being discovered. On the editorial page, the first editorial, factoring in safety. So this is regarding major industrial accidents which take place, which point to a need for stronger worker safety laws. So here you can see that is what has happened. We have seen senior officers in fire at ONGC gas facility in Navi Mumbai. So then they are stuck in fire. That's four people took place here. Then there was a tragedy that killed nearly two dozen people at a firecracker factory in Punjab. So such incidents which take place show that there's a need for stronger worker safety law. And the second editorial is hard fought glory. So this is regarding sports in tennis. At the 19th Grand Slam, with the 19th Grand Slam win, Nadal closes in on Federer's record in the race for tennis's apex. So this is regarding Nadal's victory. And here you have the drum beaters of dystopia. So this is regarding how Indian media can barely question the state narrative on Kashmir, while global outlets can only pick holes in it. So you're not allowed to question, you're not allowed to report on it. So that's spoken about over here. And this is a larger picture about inclusive programming. So this article says that India is in a unique position to scale up same language subtitling, improving both media access and reading literacy. So subtitles should be given in the same language. Like if it's a Hindi movie, then Hindi subtitles should be given. So this will improve reading literacy too, is what this article suggests. Then this is facing up to reality. So this article says that given its achievements, ISRO should not hide setbacks with the cellophane of national pride. So if there are setbacks, they have to be acknowledged, is what this article says. On page 13, you have Modi Oli open cross-border pipeline. So India-Nepal relationship will continue to intensify across multiple sectors, is what Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said during the video link launch of the Motihari Amlekhgunj energy pipeline. So this is 69 kilometer pipeline having capacity of 2 million metric ton per annum, which will provide cleaner petroleum products at affordable costs to people of Nepal. And below you have center moves to sell data from smart cities project. So starting with an open data platform for the 100 cities that are part of the smart cities mission by 2020, government now is planning to make a wide range of data from health, education, finances to social aspects of all 4,041 urban local bodies public by 2024 and eventually monetize it. So it will sell data now. On international page, you have Trump abruptly fires hardliner NSA John Bolton. So this is National Security Advisor John Bolton, considered the most hawkish among senior Trump administration officials. He has been fired by President Donald Trump. The US President said in a tweet that he strongly disagreed with many of his suggestions, as did others in the administration. So he has been fired. And here you have in Hong Kong protests, they have told US not to interfere in it. So the Hong Kong residents do not want US interference in these protests. And this is 50 US states launch probe into Google's trade practices. So Attorney General of 50 US states and territories announced that they were launching an investigation into Google's trade practices and whether they are threatening competition and harming consumers. On business page, you have Central Board of Direct Taxes refuses National Stock Exchange plea for derivative segment. So the board has said that non-compliance with SEBI rules are the reason for rejection. So to reject recognized association status request, and traders have missed the tax benefits because of this. And then on page 17, you have India-ASEAN to review free trade pact in goods. So to make the free trade pact more business friendly, a review would be conducted. The FTA was signed in 2009. So these are the important headlines. The last page has sports coverage. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.